entered the Air Force in 1987. Kind of worked my way up to be top 1% Air Force officer, one of the top test pilots in the world. I've flown about 80 to 100 different types of aircraft. From Russian MiGs, I've flown the most advanced fighters, F-15, F-16, F-18. We call it Toys for Tots at the highest level, because you get the newest, coolest, most advanced toys in the world, and you take them out and break them. So that when they encounter it in flight, then they're as prepared as we can possibly make them in case something goes wrong. And then you always find something that goes wrong. I went over 18 months where every single flight where I took off landed as an in-flight emergency. My life was all about me. My sister used to joke, I would introduce myself, "Hi, I'm Mark Shively, I fly jets, how do you like me so far?" So to me, one of the best things about being diagnosed with cancer was because it gave me a new beginning. I had cancer in my lymph system, cancer in my blood, and 96% of my bone marrow was cancerous. So over the course of about 5 years, I went through chemo over a dozen times, brain surgery to remove a growth the size of a walnut that was causing me to go blind, had my spleen removed. 3 times they told me I wouldn't live through the night. Spinal tap, lung puncture biopsies, you name it, I went through it. And to me, the saddest part wasn't that I was gonna die, the worst part would be no one would ever knew that I ever lived. My life had been all about me. There was no legacy. I had never given anything to anybody else. I had never, you know, done anything to help anybody else. And so I had to transform. I had to become a different person. So in September 2004, I went through a bone marrow transplant, went from O negative to A positive type blood. And to date, I'm the only person I know that's ever been cured. Why? After I was diagnosed with cancer, I really wanted to be a role model for cancer patients, people that have been diagnosed with incurable cancer. And so to me, I chose the most physically demanding thing that I could think of, and that was climbing Mount Everest. To me, a hero is just someone that's willing just to take that next step, and then the one after it, and then the one after it, and the one after it. And I spent basically 4 or 5 days a week climbing the mountains, did about 750,000 vertical feet, training for it. I was out climbing in the most bitter cold temperatures that I could imagine.
Here we are at our first acclimatization hike. Say hi, Kevin.
The year that we went, we had extremely cold temperatures. We had 40 straight days of snow.
Day before summit push, and had a huge storm blow through last night. Here's what's left of the dining tent.
There she is, Mount Everest.
Everest wasn't a bucket list item for me. The main reason I did it was because it was the most physically demanding thing that I could do to show cancer patients. Just because you've been diagnosed with cancer doesn't mean your life's over. And if you can connect with people and they can relate to your experiences and say, wow, that you are in a worse position than I am, I can change. I don't have to accept my life. I can start leading my life. I can make a difference now.
By being involved in Taekwondo, which is very leadership driven, he has an opportunity to shine in that arena.
He imparts his character that he already has and the wisdom he has in all other aspects of life. He imparts that in his classes that he teaches.
If you're gonna have a sport, then I wanna have the leadership on top of it. Because it's not only the power, but it's the control, it's the leadership. What are you gonna become? What are you gonna do with this? And so to me, that's one of the most important things.
It's a great, great opportunity for him to go and serve the community.
I've spoken at Youth with a Mission, their international business meeting. I've also spoke at El Paso County Workers. I spoke at Rotary Clubs. I speak at churches. I go to public libraries where these young children, to get them excited about reading, they read to a dog. We have a huge group of people that come in and these little kids read to the dog.
People change, and so I think there's still that strong person inside, but it's just a different strong person. He's just more others focused, which is the biggest change.
So I see a lot of people that put roadblocks in their life. I would like to do this, but I have cancer. I would like to be able to do that, but I have cancer. That's why we do it, because it's not just getting ourselves to the summit, it's getting other people to the summit. I know how beautiful it is. I've seen the scenery. And that's the goal of a leader, is to take everybody up to the summit so they can see a bigger picture.